to make banana bread today. It's a wonderful recipe. You need a few ingredients and then it's very simple. It all goes in one bowl in the oven and you have your banana bread. So I'm going to start. I've got 100 grams of walnuts here and I'm just going to pulse them until they're pretty fine. So they're nicely ground. I don't like chunks of walnuts in cakes. That's me personally. So you want them to be well processed. Next is my fruit. I'm sure you already know, but banana bread needs really overripe bananas, which is perfect for those bananas that sit around and no one really wants to eat them because they've gone a bit brown. So I've got 330 grams here and I'm just going to put them in the food processor. And I'm going to put them in with my tin pineapple. So this is just from a tin. I've got 260 grams here. And I'm just going to let them go. Well, until they're really, really smooth, I don't want any chunks. Just let that do its thing. So I'm just going to pour this in with my walnut. I have 330 grams of 00 flour, so that's a bit finer. And I really like it in this recipe. I'm just going to add that in there. 80 grams of desiccated coconut. Again, it really is very simple. And I'm going to give that just a little mix. I've got 300 grams of soft light brown sugar. I'm going to add that in. I'm using flax seeds as an egg replacer in this recipe. So I've got 4 tablespoons here of ground flaxseed, and I've got 10 tablespoons of water. So I'm just going to put them together. Just give that a little mix. I've got some corn oil here. I do like corn oil for this recipe. Some people use sunflower oil, but if you can, do use corn oil. So I've got 180 ml here. Recipe because it's simple, as you can see, and this makes 2 loaves. I tend to make 2 and put 1 in the freezer, and it freezes marvelously. Just put the whole thing frozen in the oven before you want it. Give it a good 45 minutes at about 180. If you've got people coming over, the smell of warm banana bread in the house seems to put everyone in a nice mood. You can see my flaxseed has become quite sort of stiff. I'm going to pop that in there. I'm going to put 2 tablespoons of vanilla extract. I'm going to put 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Cinnamon here. I really like cinnamon in this. I'm being quite heavy-handed with it. Stir that in. Cinnamon and bananas. It's a match made in heaven. Got my nutmeg here. 1 1/2 teaspoons. Baking powder here. Got 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Sprinkle that. Stir it through. Finally, my bicarbonate of soda. I'm going to put 2 teaspoons in. So quite easy to remember: 1 baking, 2 bicarb. Final mix, make sure it's really well incorporated, and then it's going to go in my tin And that is it. Got my two 30 centimetre loaf tins here, and I just combine them with some baking paper. I didn't mention, but I preheated the oven to 180 degrees. You don't need to do that more than about 15 minutes before you're going to bake your cake, so depending on how long it takes you to assemble the ingredients, you're in charge of that. And I'm going to divide it between my two tins. Slice it on a diagonal, as finely as you can slice them without them losing their shape. Again, if you can't be bothered to do this, you don't have to. They can go in the oven as they are, but I would recommend it because when it bakes, you get a lovely little crunch on top. So I'm just going to put the banana slices on top. You can decorate it in whichever way you like. Sort of put them on an angle, starting from the top. Finally, I've got my porridge oats, and I'm just going to sprinkle them on top. Just a handful. Like so. A little bit more soft, light brown sugar. And that's just all over the oats and the banana, and it's going to make it lovely and crispy. And we're ready to go in the oven, about 180 degrees for 50 minutes to an hour. I'm going to check it after about 5 minutes. My cakes are done. They smell absolutely delicious. They're golden brown on top, and I'll show you. The banana's gone all lovely and golden, and we'll just double check. We'll just insert a skewer and it comes out clean. I'm going to leave this to cool down for about 10 minutes or as long as I can bear it, and then we'll cut into it and have a taste. I'm going to cut a slice for Jay. Beautiful warm banana bread. I do hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll see you again next week for another episode of What on Earth to Eat Now.